हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास ऑफ ज्योग्राफी.
दिस टॉपिक इज इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैप. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैप. सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज मैप इज ईजी टू हैंडल. ईजी टू हैंडल दैट मीन्स what? Yes, in the previous class while I was discussing about map, in the video where I was discussing about map, I had told you that maps are very easy to roll, fold and keep it, and then you can carry it from one place to another. It is not very heavy, that you cannot take it from one place to another. So it is very easy to handle. So it is very useful for people like navigators, those who find directions, and for the travelers, those who travel from one place to another. They can keep the map with them and find the places or find the information from that map. Our second point is it shows more details. Means map shows more details in very clear format. So it is very useful for people, those who are town planners, those who prepare a town plan, and for the people, those who are in military. If it is not clear, I'll pronounce the words which I have written over here: town planners, military. So those who are in military, those who are in the town planning work, they use map and they show all the details, or they try to get all the details from the map in very correct form. So the third point is it may show particular features such as political division, physical features, etc. If you remember, in our previous class, on the basis of purpose, we have discussed that maps are political maps. There are few different types of map on the basis of purpose. So what were they? Let's revise. First one was physical map. Second one was political. Then yes, topographical. Then thematic map. And one navigational map. So when you categorize the map for different purpose and you show the information related to that only, you can represent that in more clear way. So for different purpose, we have different types of map, and we can study them according to the type of map which you have picked up. Suppose it is a political map, you are studying about the boundary lines. As I have told you in the map, political map shows us the boundaries of state, countries, districts and so on. Physical map will show you different type of physical features present in that area, landforms like rivers, mountain, lakes, etc. So this is our third point. Now our fourth point is tells us that it uses different colors and symbols. And what is the term used for this? Yes, I have told you, if you remember, it is conventional symbols. Conventional symbols are used to show different kinds of information on the map. Since the space is limited on the map, everything cannot be written. We use different colors to indicate what features are, or what features that map is trying to tell us. We use different symbols to show the location of any place. Now, so when you use these colors and symbols, for example, if you see on my board, if suppose I only write with white chalk, if I only write all the points with white chalk, you will feel boring and it may not be clear to you what all are the important points of the topic. It may not be very clear to you. So in order to make the points very clear, I have used different colors of chalk. Whatever words are important ones, I have highlighted them by using different colors. So same way in your map also, when you are trying to show different kinds of features, you use different types of colors to show whether this area is forested area. For example, if you take whether that area is a forested area, whether that area is a desert area, if you have to distinguish between them, so obviously you have to use different color for showing forested area, for showing lowland area, for showing desert area, and so on. So when you use different colors, symbols, sign, it makes your information more clear. It is easy for the user of that map to identify all the information, to collect all the information from the map. Now our last point says that features on the map are not congested. Congested means not very close, not in very for example, things are not written in very close manner, like it is not very congested means not crowdy, not clear. It is not, if you say map is not very clear, so you are wrong. Map is very clear. So congested means things are not very closely written. It is written in such a way that everything is very clear, in precise manner, in clear manner, in concise manner. See, when you concise means, C-O-N-C-I-S-E, concise means when you try to say so many things with the help of few words. When you try to say so many things with the help of few words and you are trying to convey your message with the help of few words, and you need not need many words to tell your information or tell your feelings. So same way, map indicates all the things in concise manner. So here are the points. Let's summarize this very fast. First is, it is easy to handle. Second, it shows more details. Third, it shows particular feature for different types of map. We can use different map. Thematic map shows us theme-based features like population distribution, climate distribution. Physical map, then physical map shows us different kinds of landform. Political map shows us boundary lines, and so on. Our fourth point, it uses different colors and symbols. So what is the term used for colors and symbol? Conventional symbols, which makes the thing more clear, very easy to understand. And things on the map are not congested, means it is like you will not face any problem to understand what are the things given on the map. So it is not congested. It shows everything in very clear and concise manner. So that's all for today. Thank you.